This is a second in the series of using the Hunter-Nash method for liquid extraction, where we have a ternary system. And in the first screencast, we looked at the simple two-stage system, and then we used the ternary phase diagram. We fixed the flow rate of the feed and the solvent and desired extract concentration, and then we showed how to determine the mixing point, and I won't repeat that here. And then we showed how to determine the operating point, P. And these are all based on mass balances. So what I want to do now is, once we have this operating point, how to determine the number of stages in this method. And so let me take the same diagram, but now what I've done is add in tie lines into the two-phase region. I removed the lines that helped us determine the mixing point and the operating point, so it's less complicated. And what I've left is the solvent feed, the final raffinate that we calculate for mass balances for the final extract, and what the feed is. So the first thing I'm going to do in this diagram is I'm going to change this R2 to R sub n, because when I did the initial ways of determining the mixing and operating point, I did an example with just two stages, but this is going to take more than two stages, so let's determine the number of stages. So let's look at the case where there's four stages, and I'm doing that because I've already solved the problem, and that's approximately the number of stages it's going to take. And then we had mass balances, again derived in the first screencast, that said the flow rate E1 minus F, this difference, the net flow out here, must be the net flow in here, otherwise we're not at steady state. And then we can go down each stage and say the same thing, that the net flows must be equal. I can then rearrange, and I'm going to do this because these mass balances are going to allow us to draw lines connecting, for example, E1, P, and F. We've already done that, but now E2 related to R1, E3 related to R2. So these are all mass balances. It's important to keep that in mind. The other important information is equilibrium phases. So if I look at stage 2, E2 leaving, must be in equilibrium with R2. Likewise, E1 must be in equilibrium with R1, and likewise for the other stages. And this is important because we're going to use this in the Hunter-Nash method to determine another number of stages. So let's go back now and look at this ternary diagram and say what happens. E1 leaving stage 1 is in equilibrium with R1. And so I'm going to look at this diagram, and R1 must be in equilibrium with E1, which means on a tie line. So this point then corresponds to R1. Along this tie line, we have equilibrium. We now can look at our mass balances. And so here it says that P plus R1 is E2. In other words, we get the composition E2 by summing P and R1. And that means if I draw a line between R1 and P, the intersection is going to give me the value of E2. So let's do that. So I've drawn the orange line, and this point here then corresponds to E2 from our mass balance. And then we're going to do the same thing again. E2 is going to be in equilibrium with R2. So I'm going to draw a tie line. I could certainly do it more accurately, but for this demonstration, I'm going to approximate the tie line. So I've drawn the tie line, and that means this must be R2, because remember, E2, if we go back and look at our system, E2 must be in equilibrium with R2 leaving stage 2. And therefore, we now have an equation between R2 and E3. So that means I'm going to draw another line between P and R2. So I've drawn the line between P and R2, and this means this point now is E3. Keep in mind that actually trying to draw these lines on a tablet is not really as easy to do as a piece of paper, and so it may not look quite as nice as it would if we do it on a piece of paper. Well, now E3 must be in equilibrium with R3, and so that means along this line here, this tie line, we have R3. Well, we're going to do the same thing again to find E4. So I drew the line between P and R3, and that means this point is E4. So I can follow along, and so R4 is close to our calculated value overall mass balances when we originally did this in the first screencast. So it looks like a pretty good approximation. It says it'd be slightly less than 4 stages. Of course, the accuracy of this depends very much on how good I am at drawing these lines, but the idea is what we're trying to get across here. And we can see at this point, of course, that is in equilibrium with E4 is pretty close to our original Rn value. And so we conclude that for this system, we'd take 4 stages to do the liquid-liquid extraction. And so this hopefully gives you a good idea how to apply the Hunter-Nash method to liquid-liquid extraction. We have a ternary system that we're applying it to.